this is what I'm wearing today. I have a date coming over later, supposedly, and I just wanted to show you what I'm wearing. These are hard to see, but they're like fake leather, but they're leggings, so they're shiny. They look a little bit, they have a nice seam in front. And I want to talk to you today about how to be a successful cub, because I am getting a lot of cubs who want to be cubs but want me to do all the work for them. So I just want to say to the cubs watching my videos or want to be cubs that get ready to do a lot of work yourself, because I am not here to, I can give you, point you in the general direction, but I'm not going to do all the legwork for you as far as finding specific sites to go to and all of that. So you need to do your legwork. And with that, I will go on to the video. So, keys of a successful cub. Now, get familiar with the cougar chat rooms. That's what I recommend. That's what I did when I first discovered that I was a cougar. And those chat rooms are really helpful for building one-on-one relationships and getting to know older women, and in my case, getting to know cubs. So this video is also for cougars if they want to talk to cubs. So establish some online relationships which engage in discussion about cougar-cub relationships so that you can learn and begin the next steps. Here you will learn how to approach a cougar, if not discussion about it with a trusted cougar that you get to know on that chat room, then you will find out from various trials and errors in the cougar field on the chat room if you're not having success. So next I'm going to say socialize in other areas of your life besides dating. You may become friends with cougars online who you never date, but they can be a wealth of support and information for you in your cougar dating life. So always think about people as potential friends first. That's what I do. And outside of cougar socialization, brush up on your social skills with a variety of people around you, because cougars also come in a variety of personalities. We are not all the same, and this is a common error that cubs make in thinking that all cougars can be approached the same way, or all cougars like the same things, or all cougars have the same personalities just because they date younger men. It's not true. So next, I want to say, on that same line, develop and broaden your interests in many areas so that you have something to talk about with almost anyone. Imagine cougars in every variety that they come in. All they have in common is that they date younger men. And you want to be able to be the kind of person, because they're older and have more experience than you, that can strike up a conversation and talk about anything with anyone. So go to more social functions. Learn how to talk to people you might think you don't have any interests in, and learn how to chat them up and develop common interests together, or talk about common interests together, because there's no need to focus entirely on the cougar. And I talked about this in my cougar's pet peeve video. Focusing too much on an older woman as such may become uncomfortable for her. So focusing on shared interests rather than focusing on one or the other of you is important. And it's important to realize that an older woman will likely have more developed interests in areas which you may also be interested in. So it is key to know what your interests are, and to keep your interests alive so that you can share them with her. So that's a lot of self-work. Now, next, you can try approaching cougars on online dating sites. Use what you have learned from the above endeavors to inform you how to do this. You can skip all of the above steps and go straight to online dating sites, but you may experience frustration with the trial and error phase there, as you didn't follow the above steps whereby you worked out this issue. So I think it's a lot easier to do the trial and error and how to approach a cougar in the chat rooms, so that when you go to the online dating sites where there are a lot more people, because the chat rooms tend to be smaller, then when you go on a dating site where there are a lot more random people and you've got to take anything that's thrown at you, you need that experience in the chat room first and developing your own interests. And if you go straight to online dating sites, you might get no responses because you're not doing the right things, and it might just be really frustrating for you. So it's important to pick this path and follow these steps, I think. Okay, now finally, for extra credit, read about attachment theory. Because most likely a cougar has had long relationships and learned a lot in the process. So if you're a cub and you don't have this kind of experience, you should read about attachment styles and figure out what you need in a relationship, not just what you want. You will discover that the way you were raised plays a lot into your relationships, and this will prevent a lot of frustration. A cub with self-knowledge is an attractive cub. So good luck, and let me know how your progress goes. And let me know if you have any questions or input. Okay, thank you for watching, and best of luck. Bye-bye.